Hi, I'm Li Hao. Svelte Store allows us to have a state that does not bind to the hierarchy, component hierarchy of your application. We can have a Svelte Store declared in a file, and we can have all our different components import from it. So different components, irrelevant on the hierarchy within that application, can share the same state, right? But Svelte Store itself is very flexible. It does not care about how you update it or use it, right? It's a very simple construct that allows us to subscribe to the changes of the store itself and get updates from it. And because of the store follows a store contract, we can have a very simple dollar prefix variable syntax to access the value of the store and auto subscribing to the store itself, so that whenever it's changed, the value of the variable will get updated itself. So if you are coming up with a more complex application and you are thinking about using some other libraries like state management libraries or state machines to control your state, then you might think that maybe if that's the case, then are we losing out, not able to leech on using the dollar prefix variable syntax? Well, maybe not. As long as we can make the library itself follows a store contract, then we can actually leverage on the Svelte dollar prefix syntax to subscribe to the value of whatever libraries that you're using, so that you can have a control in terms of how the state changes from one to another. Yet at the same time, when you're using it, you can still use the dollar prefix syntax to get updated every time whenever the state has changed. So today we're going to look at one state machine library that has gained some hype in the JavaScript world recently, which is XState. So right now we are looking at the GitHub page of XState. It says that it is a state machine and state charts for the modern web. And as you scroll down below, you see that it has a lot of sub-packages, such as the finite state machine for XState, utilities or hooks for React, for Vue, and testing libraries, and inspection utilities, and a lot of templates that you can get started with, as well as the XState with Svelte template over here. Let's take a look at the docs or APIs. So over here, we have opened up XState's APIs. You can see a quick start guide will be installing XState and creating a state machine. So I'm not going to delve into how you're going to do that. But so we can start with defining the state machines, and then we interpret the machines, which when you run start, it will give you a service where you can send actions to transition from one state to another. And you can, and then this service, you can, based on the service value, you can know whether which state are you at currently right now. Right, so I have started this. I've copied all over this into a Svelte code. So over here, I have data.js, which has defined the state machine, and I have started the machines like the docs have specified. And over here with toggle service, it has apparently a subscribe method, which gives us the current state. And this state, so we assign the states to the current state. And so we can use the states which has methods like matches to tell us whether it matches, whether the state currently is an active or active, right? As well as it has like, it returns an unsubscribe method. And to send actions, we are toggling the service like send toggle and stuff. So if we take a look at this toggle service variable, does it follow the Svelte store contract? Well, okay, let's see. So first of all, it has a subscribe method. Check once. And the function within the subscribe methods has one parameter, which is the state, which is the state that you will get. Check two, right? Then if you can see here, the subscribe method, this function get called immediately, right? So I just do this. I don't have to initialize the value of states, but right over here, when you console out, you can see the state already, which means the moment when we call subscribed, this function will be get called and it will update the variable states, right? Check tree, which means the function itself will get called synchronously immediately when you start subscribing it. Right? Then this variable itself, when you call subscribe, it should return a function, which is the unsubscribe, which you can call to unsubscribe the service, check for, basically, as the basic mandatory of a store contract, having the subscribe method that fulfills all this check, which means it is following the store contract. What does that mean? It means that actually you can use dollar prefix syntax of this toggle service and actually gets the state value immediately, right? So over here, instead of state, which is the value from this state, we can use toggle service, but with a dollar prefix, which is getting the value of that's the service or the states of your XState service, right? And let's try and see. Everything works still works fine, which means that we can remove all this code. Remove on destroy, remove all this, and everything still works as expected. Let's see, let's refresh. Yeah, everything still works. So, very simple, nothing much to do for using XState in Svelte, because the XState service has already been following Svelte store contract, and that's so easy to use XState in Svelte. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have anything you want to comment about, ask me about, comment down below. And as always, if you please remember to subscribe to my channel so that you get notified on the next video. So see ya, bye bye.